Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to the... Oh, I forgot to do that. Ugh, choppiness! Welcome to the 50th episode. This is going to be an extra long episode. Maybe we'll finish this secret lab, which it's called. Now, there's another area. I'm just going to restart really quick because I had choppiness. I wasn't sneaking. Yeah. There's another building here. Looks like a separate... Oh, there's another building over there. I wonder if that's the storage. Or if this is the storage. But anyway, we gonna be looking for a cigarette lighter for her. And I know my weapon is damaged. Oh yeah, my grenade launcher is not in good condition. Well, if it gets more damaged, you know, too much further damaged, I'm gonna be using the assault rifle and the vermin. This thing shrinks enemies for a very short amount of time, so I think I want to increase my science skill before I do that. Does anyone need to level up or anything? No. Nope, unfortunately no. Alright. Going into silent mode. I already looked in there then. Covert lamp. It's covert and secret. Elite troop armor. I am very close to being overweight here. Now entering Auntie Cleo's secret lab. Remember to keep Auntie's secrets secret. This is not operational. So we're supposed to incapacitate these things. If possible. At very least, the mother. They're not canids. What are they called again? Raptidons. Use the lab's equipment to gas and incapacitate the beast. Raptidon mother in particular. Well, it depends. If we come across the lab first, or we come across the Raptidons first. Let's open that one too. Let's see. I guess we need to file out of here in a hurry. That gives a lot of damage per second. Stun Baton Ultra. Shock Cannon. I really just don't. I don't use them though. Let's see, I'm gonna break it down. Pick it on down. It didn't give me a lot of weight back. Did I? Sorry, I like pistol. It's really the armor that's gonna do that, I guess. So elite troop armor. Yeah, how much elite troop armor do we need? Pristine. This one's in pristine condition. That helps. 38. Yeah, get that helmet to somebody. Oh yeah, Parvati. So he's using 16. Let's give him this. What am I using, actually? 30. I should be using elite troop armor. Hell. So this is pristine, yet it's also damaged. How is that possible? So 30 and 26. What is Parvati using? 13, really? And max 16. There you go. I can't break it down unless I'm in my inventory. Okay. She's using a light machine gun. 320. Actually, I'm really looking at the damage underneath skill. 19. What do you think, Parvati? You want a heavy machine gun? Let's give her a heavy machine gun. Hell yeah. Lock and load. And he's using a tactical shotgun. Alright, I'll keep him with that. 173, 238, 14 times 12, 24 times 8. Alright, yeah, we'll keep him with what we have here. Corporate recruit. Guys okay in here?
Who the... you. Yeah, you. Get over here.
I'm here.
You care to explain what you're doing here? Did you miss the big sign outside?
Yeah, it's a great way to keep a secret. Anton sent me to help. You in charge of security?
That I am. Name's Porter. Doc Crane did send you. I'd be glad for the help. Bad news is, we haven't been able to clean these outlaws out of the lab. Good news is, they haven't been able to escape, neither.
Could they get out through the vents?
That's how they got in. We got that locked down. There's no access from their level without a security keycard. That also means no fresh air down there. Probably reeks of Raptidon musk. Couldn't happen to a nicer bunch.
How have you been dealing with the Raptidons?
They don't care which side their lunch is on, but the Rapt cells are down with the outlaws, so they're the appetizers. When it looks like they're fixing to make a sally upwards, I have a sniper pop the lock on a Rapt cell. It's kept them busy.
That's pretty damn clever.
Thanks. Company will probably bill me, but better lose a rap than get shot, I says.
Right, so it's a stalemate.
For now. I reckon they got no backup. On the other hand, we don't neither. And our mechanicals all went haywire for some damn reason. Damn mechanicals have always been more trouble than they're worth.
You locked down the vents the attackers entered through, you said. Are you sure they'll hold?
Pretty damn sure. The shafts are sealed with 4-centimeter hatches. They're not getting back out that way without a security key card. They'd need to take mine. Or make a new one in my office, I guess.
Where can I find your office?
Why you want to know that?
I need a security key card.
What for?
I'm going down after these guys. I don't want to get trapped by a door you locked behind you.
Fair point. Here's your key card to my office. Head left from here and downstairs. It's across from the cafeteria. I got a machine that makes pass cards for us.
Okay.
Just don't knock over any paperwork in there. I got a system.
So got a key card to go get a key card. What exactly do you do here? I guess security?
Who, me? Or you mean the lab in general?
The lab in general, actually.
Soap or something? I don't know. Years back, they made antibiotics. You could maybe ask Doc Crane what he does all day.
I actually found out. You don't care at all? What if it's something illegal?
If it was illegal, the company wouldn't ask us to do it.
What about you, Porter? What do you do here?
I'm in charge of site safety engineering. Most days that means making sure folks don't run in the halls.
Pretty quiet out here, huh? Normally, I mean?
Most days there ain't nothing to hear but wind, bugs, and the buildings falling slowly to pieces.
Yeah, falling to pieces while you live in them.
Well, it's not like the rain's coming in the roof. Not yet, anyway.
Alright, well, that's enough. Those outlaws won't wait forever. Hi.
Carry on.
Do I get to keep calm too? A little combat drone. I can just take this stuff? You guys don't mind?
I don't have time for this.
You best to have time for it.
Carry on.
Bard. Looks like a messy exhaust. Better than nature. You say so. So this helmet is 26. I got 38. Oops. She's got 20. Max is 17. All right. I'm saving this for Felix. Unless I find better. Cool. I'm actually gonna break that down too. Now, there shouldn't be anything over here. Never mind. They said they'd be malfunctioning. Wasn't aware I meant malfunctioning as far as they will attack.
We've got a fight on our hands.
Well, these guys are gonna help.
Everyone all right?
He isn't. Porter died. Sorry, Porter. I wasn't aware he was gonna run in. Well, we got another key card. Well, that's unfortunate. Light Assault Rifle Mark II. Oh, yeah. I'm still overweight. Breakdown bonus. Sawed-off shotgun or tactical shotgun? Let's get rid of this. Okay. So we've got that door. We've got this. And we've got this. I'm figuring I get zapped around here. Wait. That didn't do anything. I thought it was gonna be a bigger explosion. I am not hitting that thing, am I? Oh, we're running in, okay? Crap. Someone getting up that was gonna fight us. Enclosed padded helm. Breaking it down, F. So another one of these light assault rifles. I should give that to one of these guys. And another. Some Adreno. Is no one of these good helmets? Yeah. It's telling me to use Adreno. I mean, medical inhaler, which is Adreno. Yeah. So I've been updating these guys. 20. 26. He's got 26 also. So Parvati. And I'll get this advanced armor. I might save this for Felix. Oh yeah. I don't know why I'm finding a safe spot. Light pistol. Ooh, really? This is better, isn't it? Damage. Oh no, maybe not. This damage 1, 2, 3. The magazine size is higher, though. Not sure. But we've got these light assault rifles, which are 58, 58, which I just gave to myself. Okay. You guys are getting light assault rifles. There you go. These are really good DPS. Oh. And what the hell, yeah. I can't keep it all, it's just too much. Oof, I feel like I gotta sneeze. And I did sneeze. Okay, so this was his 200 natural health. I know we have other things that do that. That's a lumpy slice of fresh Raptidon. What else does that? Because I take the inhaler one more time, this is going to be empty. Sultuna, that's his base health. Nanners? Do I have those mock apples? Yeah, we have four of those. Five of these, wait a second. There we go. I'll just take it, what the hell. Trying to drop a little weight. Machine. Still have to see where those other two doors go. Yay, Adreno. Yay, Adreno. Light ammo in there, okay. Security blade, I'll break that down. And that. And then the vending machine. Okay, where option two? Knocked over the refrigerator. At the junk. Yeah. Does that drop weight? No. That drops weight. Alright. I'm gonna just keep one of each. I should really just store the extras on the ship. Wait, I wanted to drop. Yeah. Have one left. Alright, that helps. A little bit. I really need all this stuff, right? And at this point, I have more than I'll probably ever use. Can I click that as well? Oh, I click that. Okay. Just trying to fix our weight problem. We'll get 18 of these things. That helps a lot. Okay. Boop. Alright. I want to run back up and see what all those other doors go. Could be like storage areas or something. So where's this go? Let me just take care of this again. So if I get another pistol, my pistol mark, oh, I have it. Yeah, get rid of this one. Here we go. What's in here? Ah, see, just the bathroom. But a few goodies to be had. Riot control helmet. Oh, we got goodies back there. Heavy grade face. Okay, let me take a look at these helmets. 11 armor. Gives you determination bonus, though. Oh, yeah. Let's see if we can get our way in here.
Handled beautifully.
Thank you. Armor parts. That's it? There's some armor parts? Alright. I have plenty of lockpicks.
That was quick.
Empty bin. Toss ball card, Thomas B. Henry. The latest Thunder Tender. Henry has proved himself the master of the Thursday Zone. Precision Spectrum Magnification Mono Lens. The best in safety wear for when you really want to protect your eyes, sight. Engineering plus 5. And that's the tech skills plus 5. What's that book? Broaden your horizons with a little light reading. I have no idea what book it is, but it's a book. This is really light. I'll hold on to it. Oh, we have these too. He died holding it. So I have 59.
Easy.
So it's saying lockpick used, but am I using them? I always have 59, no matter what. Maybe not. Because it says 0. I just don't know why it would say lockpick used then. Oh, just one Adreno? Alright. Containment cell control terminal. Please enter a command. Let me guess, you open it. That opens the doors. Now there's nothing to do. Can I close the doors again? Let me see. No, alright, never mind. This requires some.
Great work.
Oh, we got a workbench. I need a workbench. Vented Mark III helmet. 5 more lockpicks. Cool. We got plenty of materials to use. You know more than others. Relies on your discretion. Employer rights under the Biased Labor Standards Act, wage determined by merit of your work. Overtime may result in higher pay if the quality of said work is considered exemplary. Your employer has the right to dock your pay should you damage any facilities or equipment. It is your responsibility, not your employer's, to avoid workplace hazards. Halcyon Colony Department of Labor. Yeah, it's typical. Yeah, I'm definitely going to use the workbench. I'm going to check this out. Anything else? Wait. artisanal. Tired of ishy acid burns? Yeah, those are always a problem. Try Anticleo's artisanal boar scented moisturizing cream. Why would you want it to be scented like that? So like all of these say, it's on security lockdown, maintenance logs. Week 1. 06's patrol route passed too close to the experimental subject pens. Now there's wrapped spit gunking up the servos in its gun arm. We don't have a replacement arm, so guess we disassemble this one for parts. At least 12 and 17 are still working. Week 2. Someone tried to disable the mandatory consumer broadcast on 17. The thing got stuck in maximum volume mode until we factory reset it. Week 4. 12 had a serious malfunction today. Porter accidentally tripped one of the sensors inside the walls, so the blasted unit thought everyone was an intruder and just started shooting. We shut it down for now, but we've requested new behavior modules from HQ for the rest of the units. Week 4. No response on the behavior modules. For the time being, we'll have to hope nobody blows up a wall. Yeah? That'll be a problem. Okay, I'm going to repair my grenade launcher. And my shrink ray. And my Deadeye Assault Rifle. Wait a second. I like this one better. I'm gonna break down that for parts. Repair this though. And how's my armor? Tinker. Tinkering. I'm just improving everyone's armor here. That's expensive. Let's just go for it. Okay. This stuff requires a lot. Oh, this is vented Mark III helmet. Iconoclast helmet. This old model Hephaestus helmet was intended for mining and work in high particulate areas. Now it's just headgear for apolitical nonconformists. 17 armor. It's better than what I have here. This is going to be Felix's helmet. I'm not sure. I think he has a helmet already. Just don't know. So, I'm going to get this for his helmet so far. I don't want to tinker with it because I might find a better one. Same with the armor. I could tinker with it back at the ship if I have any money. Okay. So, I'm glad I went back and checked this stuff out. I didn't want to miss anything. So that was the bathroom. Yeah, so... no other doors. All this sparks and water can't be a good combination. Oh, we got this. Whatever's back here. Don't you shush me. Alright. Anton's. Oh, this is Anton's office. The safe has been forcibly opened, with its contents tossed about haphazardly. The remaining notes refer to various aborted projects. Anton's prize research is nowhere to be found. Scorch marks along the rim suggest the work of unsubtle thieves. Outlaws most likely made off with Anton's work. I wonder if...
I guess that all the nothing in that safe isn't what we were expected to find.
I wonder... well, I wonder if the... whoever took it is still here. I am still gonna look around for anything. Like magpics.
Where are we headed?
She said something, so I figured she might have something else to say. I meant to break some of this stuff down. Or should I save one for Felix? This was damaged already. I should have fixed that. I didn't fix these two weapons? Anton Crane, Project Winter Blue Mount, from G. Trammell. Jeff Trammell, Project Director. The latest batch is showing great promise, Anton, and though I hesitate to tempt the fates, I might even dare to say it's a smashing success. Incidents of cavities have dropped significantly in the test subjects using the toothpaste, with only minor side effects. Nothing too serious, mind you, just a touch of blindness. So if you could look into it, that would be much appreciated. Keep this up and you'll find yourself in Byzantium post-haste. Blindness, okay. Glad my toothpaste doesn't make me blind. These are all from Jeff Trammell. Upon further review of your results, we uncovered something quite fascinating. While the toothpaste does reduce cavities, it does so only nominally more than the current version. Our results were skewed by the fact that our test subjects had a marked decrease in appetite, and hence were eating much less. That will teach us to monitor our subjects more closely, eh? Seriously, though, the appetite suppressant qualities of this new formulation are quite incredible, though the taste and texture leave something to be desired. So we'd like for that to be your focus moving forward. No need to waste any more time on the blindness thing. We've got the boys in marketing working on a solution on our end. Wow. All these corporation people are completely evil. Seriously, Anton, you really must let the whole blindness thing go. Your dedication to solving it is admirable, but also a bit misguided, I dare say. Okay, so this guy, Anton, is actually a good guy compared to Jeff Trammell. It's really not that big of an issue, and the grand scope of this whole thing pales in comparison to the texture and flavor issues, which we'd prefer for you to spend all your time on. You're also mistaken about our ultimate goal for the project. The appetite suppressant qualities make this something much more valuable in the townships than even in Byzantium. The need for less food to satisfy our workers can add greatly to our bottom line, so marketing is focusing their efforts in that direction. I'm not certain, but that may have something to do with them rejecting your Appazap suggestion for the name. Let's leave marketing to the marketing department, shall we? Wow. What do you think about that?
By verity, by strength. Okay. What are we contemplating today?
How evil this Jeff Tramiel guy is. The name reminds me of Jack Tramiel. Was he in... Oh, missed that. It was Commodore, but I think it was Atari before that? I'm not even sure. So I want to go... I want to go back to the workbench. I missed that guy. That is not the workbench. That is the bathroom. Yeah, I don't know why I spaced on that. Oop. Alright, so we've got this door off the cafeteria. And then we've got a door here, and they've got some kind of bay or something over there. That's just all the stuff I dropped. Elite Troop Armor. I can't see the number because... 26. Okay, this is... Okay, good. That's what I want for Felix. So we're gonna break this down. Bravati's using the ordnance control. And he's using the elite troop armor improved to 36. Tempt to go back and improve the other one up to 36, but I'll do it on the ship. I might find better armor in the meantime, so... Keep forgetting to break these things down on the fly. Auto mag. Sedative gas canister? A label on the canister reads, Anti-Cleo's Raptigon is guaranteed to render even the largest Raptidon unconscious for no less than 6 hours and has a refreshing antiseptic scent. Should a method for gas dispersal be found, this canister may prove very useful. Alright. What does the codex want now? Probably some logs here. Yeah, Anton's safe was broken into and his data is missing. Looks like the outlaws swiped it. You found a canister of sedative gas. There should be sufficient to subdue the Raptidons in the facility. The canisters must be installed near the ventilation system in the Raptidon incubation chamber. Huh. Okay. Good to know. Where's the Raptidon incubation chamber? Anything up there? Alright, so we've got two doors actually. This one requires some magpicks.
Nicely done.
Storage. I have four weapon parts from that. Here's another set of gas canister. It's just in case. Adreno, ammo. Mop and bucket. So this is... Yeah, still off this... chamber here. Okay. This goes out here, where we were. There's that bay over there, whatever that is, and then there's this.
You reckon it's normal in a lab like this to just leave weapons all over? Or is it just whoever works here?
Probably because they're dead. Some bits. Heavy machine gun. I have a heavy machine gun already. Let's break this one down. All right, terminal. Another gas canister. Are these weighing things? I keep picking them up. Oh, times three. Alright. Full of Raptidon sedation gas. I don't think this stuff weighs anything. The quest items. Or the junk. Oh, this actually does weigh stuff. Never mind. Pulse hammer, I'll break it down as well. As far as I know, you can't break down things that like just laying around, not in a container. Alright. So I hope you find out where to use these gas canisters. Messages. From E. Finley. Orson Shaw. Okay, this is his stuff. He wanted me to look at this. Isn't it him? Or maybe, no, that's Vaughn. Okay, who's Orson Shaw? Sounds familiar. Anton. It's all about Anton. Recover Anton's data. The terminal in Chief Porter's office. It can print out a security key card. Did I miss that? I didn't print out a security key card. Oh, outdoor Raptidon pen. Oh, we're not going to find a cigarette case in there. Never mind. Talk to Anton. Do with the abandoned experiment. It's Vaughn Cortez. Never mind. Vaughn, Anton's research. Alright, never mind. Orson Shaw sounds so familiar. Better than nature. Okay, from E. Finley. Orson, you assured me the new lunch rations are harmless, but I've experienced an unexpected flood of symptoms. I've logged irregular seepage every afternoon between 1423 and 1443. It's 2:43 p.m., you guys. Please find what I consider evidence deposited in your mailbox. From Porter. Orson, I took our auto mechanical parts back. I catch you swiping for maintenance again. I'll slap you down so hard they'll feel it in Byzantium. We've got enough problems keeping them contraptions running. From Vaughn Cortez. Hey Orson, if you're up to it, there should be a new batch of concentrated distillate available tonight. Meet me outside the gate at 1700. Alright, so that's it for that. Unfortunately, that's not research or anything I can do anything with. I'm looking carefully at all the papers and such, just in case it's something I... Thank you. Couldn't pick up. So I guess that's it, except for going this way. What am I seeing over there?
Hey! You! Over here!
Where? How do you see me? Oh. Cassandra O'Malley! How do you see me? I was sneaking. Don't these coolant tanks weigh a lot? It's like a trash thing. They do. They weigh 1.5. I'll be right with you, Cassandra. So we've got door we've got up there. Something going on up there. Hi.
Oh, good. You're not shooting at me. That's a start. It's been a bit of a day, so I'll get to the point. Yes, I have Crane's research. No, I'm not giving it back. Sorry to disappoint you.
Should I lie? I know it gives me experience. I've never met anyone named Crane.
I suppose it does not matter. Either Crane sent you, or you are some scavenger come to rob me in my moment of weakness. Let's make a deal. I'd like to go on living. You'd probably like to make some money. Help me get out of here, and I will pay you for your trouble.
Why are you down here?
Same reason you are, more than likely. I imagine we picked up the same tip. Secret research facility, abandoned town, minimal security.
Doesn't look like minimal security to me, or abandoned.
No, but it is a secret. Well hidden. Off the map. Any place worth hiding is worth raiding. Granted, diet toothpaste is not exactly what comes to mind when I imagine secret research and underground labs.
Did you say diet toothpaste?
Diet toothpaste. Can you imagine a more pernicious example of corporate materialism? I do not know what is worse. Working here or dying here.
So you went through all this trouble to steal a formula for diet toothpaste.
What matters is that I have been lied to. I was led to believe this was a high-priority corporate facility hiding valuable research. This job was not supposed to end with me stuck in some wretched lab smelling like rats. So I would be very much obliged if you gave me a break.
What's in it for me?
You mean other than the satisfaction of doing me a good turn? Trust me, I'll make it worth your while.
I don't know. My while is worth a lot. I like that.
I am good for my word. You will be equitably rewarded on my honor. But I will not haggle or bargain with you until you help me.
Tell me what you need.
The first thing I need is a key card to unlock my door. Then I'd need you to clear me a path out of here. There are two ways out. The quickest is through the front door, but Cleo security is bottled up in there. If you don't want to shoot them, I suppose you could talk to them. The other way out is through the loading bay, but you'd have to clear out the wraps for me. Then I could just slip out the back, sight unseen.
And then you just leave, and then I don't get anything out of this. Anton was worried you might have made off with his research. He even called you cretins.
So you lied about not knowing Crane. I suppose I do not blame you.
Yeah.
We liberated that research. We did not steal it. And yes, a few scientists were caught in the crossfire.
Nice to know you aren't burdened with a conscience.
You misreckon me. My conscience is what keeps me from throwing in with these corporate parasites. I would rather die than spend my life in a lab coat researching diet toothpaste.
You don't seem to care much for that research. May as well hand it over. I know it's not gonna work.
It is my one bargaining chip. If you want this research, you will help me out of this mess.
I'm gonna need a good reason to risk my neck for you. I'm trying to get her to give me more. Something, I don't know.
Because Crane is a tool. Because no good deed goes unrewarded. Because doing me a good turn is the honorable and decent thing. Take your pick.
Why do you think Anton is a tool?
Crane is being used by Auntie Cleo. And now he is trying to use you. So what does that make you?
Not trapped in an underground laboratory with half my crew dead.
Fair. But while I may be trapped for the moment, those scientists are trapped in corporate slavery for the rest of their sad, sorry little lives. Don't you see? I am setting these people free. I am doing them a favor. Won't you do me one in return?
For free? No.
I do not want charity. I will put something pretty in your palm for your trouble. You have got my word on that.
All right, I'll help you out.
You might be the first stroke of luck I've had all day. Thank you. I'm in your debt.
Hold on, I've got some questions about you.
Ask away. I have got nothing but time.
What do you intend to do with this research?
Sell it, of course. I don't have any use for the scribblings of idiotic scientists, but whoever gave me this tip obviously does. Assuming I make it out of this place alive. And with my ship out of commission, I'll have to leave on foot and hope my luck changes. One problem at a time, I suppose.
Why would you and your crew raid an anti-Cleo facility? Let me guess. Secrets.
No one asks why anymore. The establishment tells us to live here, work there, eat that, drink this. All our choices are made for us, so we forget we ever had a choice. I am doing this because I can. Because it thrills me. Because I take a deep and profound pleasure from stabbing at the heart of corporate power, no matter how shallow the wound.
How did you end up in this mess?
I have been asking myself the same question. Our tactics were sound, but no battle plan survives contact with the enemy. We were acting on a good tip, but the tip never mentioned the Rapts. When we hit the lab, those Rapts got loose, tore through as many of ours as theirs.
Tell me more about what you have against the corporations.
From the day we are born, we are made to obey. Never question, never hope. Never dream of anything greater than the lot appointed to us.
And in your case, never doing an honest day's work, apparently.
Huh.
Corporations expect us to work until the day we die. But they could not give a half-bit shit about our lives.
What am I getting myself into if I help you out?
Nothing beyond the purview of a talented freelancer like you.
Your door is stuck fast. How did you manage to lock yourself in?
The Rapts took us by surprise, as they would anyone. My crew were split apart and lost in the corridors. They went one way, I went another. You'll need a keycard to unlock my door. I don't know where they're kept, but I'd start by checking the security office.
Yeah, I guess we missed that.
Ask away. I have got nothing but time.
How do I get back to that persuade option?
I have been asking myself. We were acting on a good tip, but the tip never mentioned the Rapts. Nothing beyond the purview of a talented freelancer like you.
I'm gonna save that for last. Tell me what you know about the Raptidons.
A Raptidon is an apex predator, native to the jungles of Monarch. They are entirely unsuited to life on Terra 2, which may account for their horrible temper and appetite.
That was an unexpectedly scientific answer.
What? Do not give me that look. I am allowed to have hobbies. Biology happens to be one of them.
I didn't say can't have
yes,
hobbies.
Yes, we accidentally released the Rapts into the world when we attacked this place. But I am not at fault here. Those scientists had no business experimenting on these creatures.
Did you expect me to take down an entire pack of these things?
Oh, for goodness sake. They are just animals. Aggressive, territorial, frightened, and very probably hungry animals, but they die to gunfire like anything else.
It's true.
I do remember one of those feckless scientists yammering something about a Raptidon suppression system.
Where can I find the scientist?
How should I know? I left his body where I shot him.
I can talk the guards into leaving, but your people have to let them pass.
You really expect me to just let them pass? Why? So they can regroup behind their walls and mount another assault? Never mind. I'm obviously in no position to argue with you. If you can talk those guards into standing down, my people will follow suit.
Is there something else I need to know?
I'll help however I can.
All right, wait here.
Take your time. I am, to my chagrin, not going anywhere.